हमारे इस सेशन में जो अगली प्रस्तुति होने वाली है वो डॉक्टर संजय औटी इनके तरफ से होगी। इनका मैं अल्प सा परिचय देना चाहूंगी। डॉक्टर संजय औटी ये वनस्पति शास्त्र विभाग के प्राध्यापक है, हेड है, एचओडी है एचपीटी आर्ट्स एंड आरवा के साइंस कॉलेज नासिक में वो कार्यरत है। उनका नैसर्गिक संसाधनों के ऊपर बहुत अच्छा अभ्यास है और वो बहुत सारे लोगों को जैसे विद्यार्थियों को, प्राध्यापकों को और उनके ही साथ किसानों को इस विषयों पे मार्गदर्शन करते हैं। मैं संजय औटी सर से विनती करूंगी कि वो अभी प्रस्तुति दे।
थैंक यू। तो आवाज आए कोई व्यवस्थित?
हो सर।
हेलो, अलग आवाज?
हो सर, आवाज है तो।
ओके ओके, मी स्क्रीन शेअर करतो। फक्त मला विचारायचं आधी की की मीडियम कुठलं असेल, मराठी की इंग्लिश?
सर कुठलंही चालेल मीडियम,
कुठलं कम्फर्टेबल सांगा मला फक्त।
हिंदी किंवा इंग्लिश बरं पडेल।
ओके ओके। Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. First of all, I am very much thankful to organizer and all the members of Prithvi Moolaji Foundation for giving me opportunity to share my work and experiences. Today I have chosen topic millets, a solution to agrarian, nutritional and climatic changes. Now let's try to understand what are millets exactly and how these millets help to solve agrarian or nutritional and climatic challenges. So what are the burning issues nowadays? What are the issues or what are the challenges in all the countries of the world? And I'm not saying only in India, but all the countries of the world, you will find three important issues. These three issues are malnutrition, then land issues, what we call agrarian issues, and third one is change in climatic condition or effect of changing climate condition on agriculture or the entire globe. So when we talk about malnutrition and micronutrient deficiency, this is one of the most important issues, because throughout the world you will find number of people suffered by calcium deficiencies or iron deficiency anemia or the deficiency of various micronutrient because of n number of things. And the most important is change in food habit. And when we talk about malnutrition or micronutrient deficiencies, then obviously remember you will find number of issues or number of aspects deals with this issue. Then number two, land issues or agrarian issues specifically deals with the shifting of the land or the field issues, soil issues, and deals with the depletion or corrosion of the soil or depletion and exhaustion of soil because of heavy and faulty irrigation affected or causes the development of saline soil or the soil with very high alkalinity and water logging condition. Soil fertility is one of the most important issue as far as the agrarian challenges are concerned. But nowadays, all of you know, in number of states as far as the India is concerned, then specifically Punjab, Maharashtra, in such state you will find the excess use of fertilizers and fungicides, pesticides, shifting of land. Because of all these, you will find the agrarian issues, which is one of the most important as far as agriculture field is concerned. Then third one is change in climate. Now this changing climatic conditions affected all the agricultural crops. Specifically, it affected the growth and yield of all the crops and ultimately economy of the country. So all these issues, land issues, malnutrition issues, or change in climatic issues, all these issues work in hand. It's not possible to separate the agriculture issue or the agrarian issues from the micronutrient deficiencies or the malnutrition, or we should not, it's not possible to separate the climatic issues as far as the agriculture crops are concerned. So these are the burning issues as far as the today's scenario is concerned. So when we talk about agriculture, agriculture is the solution, one of the best solution as far as these issues are concerned. And when we talk about agricultural crops, then millets are most important. So what are millets exactly? And how it differ from other crops? So these millets are small grain cereals. They are cereals only like wheat, but they are small grain cereals. So we can differentiate millets from the rest of the cereals. And the popular millets are bajra and jawar, what we call the pearl millet and sorghum. But apart from these two, there are other six millets, and these millets are highly ignored. And these millets are finger millet, barnyard millet, little millet, kodo millet, foxtail millet, and proso millet. Here you can see these are the six millet, which are called as the minor millets. In most of the states, are people aware with these two millets only, jawar and bajra, or pearl millet and sorghum. But rest of the millets are not known. These millets, for example, finger millets in Marathi is called as a nasni or nagli. So here I have given the vernacular name and the botanical name of each millet. So when we talk about these six millet, then again here we can group, because out of these millet, finger millet is little bit known as compared to rest of the millets. So these are the types of the millets. Now let's see the importance of the millets. Why these millets are important? When we talk about other agricultural crops, or when we compare with the other crops, for example, pulses, wheat, or maize, rice, because we are emphasizing on these crops only. And we ignore one of the most important group of the cereal, or one of the most important group of crop, that is millets. So why these millets are important? These millets are important because they are highly nutritious. I'll come to this point, why these millets are nutritious, what exactly the millets contain. then millets are drought resistant and required few external inputs. These millets are grown in wide environmental condition. These grown in most of the African and Asian countries, where you will find the drought conditions. And one more thing is that, as compared to other crops, millets won't require much more external inputs or won't require much more water or the fertilizers. Then next is millets provide both with food and fodder. All the millets or the six millet, I'm talking about minor millets only. I'm not emphasizing on jowar and bajra or pearl millet and sorghum. So all these six millets can be used as a food and fodder, means they can provide security, food security or fodder security in any kind of environment or in any season. Then millets, all the millets are based or they can be used in different cropping system or mixed cropping system, and these millets shows maximum genetic diversity. Means shows maximum types of land races or the local varieties, because whatever varieties developed by the agricultural universities, people, because millets are mostly tribal or mostly the crop which grown in the hilly area or grown by the tribal farmers, and tribal farmers not afford to purchase seeds from the uni or seeds from the agriculture universities or from the shops. So mostly these people use conventional seeds. So obviously millet shows very, very huge diversity. And this diversity helps to maintain the overall scenario or of agro biodiversity. Next important point is that, as I said, this crop millets, they are drought resistant, required very few inputs, and the most important thing is that this is the crop only which can help to reduce carbon dioxide in atmosphere or carbon sequestering crop, because the crop is, crops belongs to specific group, and that group is called as a C4 plants. C4 plants or C3 plants, this C4 or C3 deals with the fixation of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Means here in the simple word, I would like to clear you that millets are the crop which are able to fix this carbon dioxide from the atmosphere by a specific pathway, and the pathway is very unique. Because of that pathway, the crop is highly resistant and capable to reduce the carbon dioxide, or we can say it's a carbon sequestering crop. And the most important thing is that this crop is the part of our culture. Millet is the part of culture. If you move around the Nasik region, or if you move around the tribal part of India, or even if you go to Africa, then you will find that this, all the millets, what are the millets are there, minor millets are the part of culture. And these, all the millets, they introduced in the India before 3000 years. When we talk about the origin of the millets, specifically finger millets or the nathni crop like nathni, then all these crops appear in the African country, specifically the center of origin is Ethiopia. In African countries, specifically in Ethiopia, this crop appear before 5000 year, but in India it introduced before 3000 year, and now it become the part of इंडियन कल्चर. So here you can see the distribution of millets. When we talk about these millets, finger millet, little millet, foxtail millet, proso millet, kodo millet, and barley are millet. Then, as far as our country is concerned, India is concerned, here you will find the distribution of all these millet. If you go through the distribution, you will realize that all the millets are specifically grown in the hilly region or the region where other crops fail to grow. Here remain the map of Maharashtra. Here you can see the distribution of millets. Specifically, you will find the tribal part of Amravati, Melghat region, or the Marathwada region, some part, then Konkan region, then Gadchiroli, and some part of Chandrapur, then Nasik region, Pet, Surgana, Harsul region, and the some part of Pune and Ahmednagar region. For example, the region nearby the Bhandara or the Akola. Here you will find the ample or the good cultivation of this crop. But with the changing scenario, you will not find much more production of all these millets because of n number of things. And the most important factors are there's a dramatic decrease in the area of cultivation. Remember, whatever the millets are there, as compared to wheat, maize, rice, you will find decrease in area under cultivation. So these are the figures, 80% for the small figures, 80% for the small millet, then 46% for the finger millet. Now, when we compare all this with the wheat, rice or maize, then all these decrease, it's a dramatic decrease. Then when we again talk about the total production of minor millets, then it's only the 76%. And apart from the number of qualities, apart from the drought resistance crop, or despite from the nutritional attributes, all the millets are highly ignored. Why this crop lag behind? Why the production of the millets are very less as compared to other crops or other cereals? As I said, number of factors are responsible. These are the few factors. For example, green regulation is one of the most important here, because before green regulation, people emphasize on the cultivation of different types of millets. But after green regulation, there is change in the trend, and farmers, government, policymaker, scientists, all these people emphasize on the cultivation, improvement, and production of crops like wheat, maize, and cereal. So as compared to these crops, means all these people, policymakers, or the farmers, all these people emphasize on the production, on the cultivation of these three crops only, or specifically cash crops. And when we compare with the cash crops, nobody looks, or these people ignore the importance of millet. Then next is the lack of high yielding varieties. As I said, scientists also ignore this crop during the course of time. When we talk about the wheat, then you will find number of high yielding varieties. Or in case of rice, you will find number of varieties. But as far as the millets are concerned, for example, the Kodra, Kutki, or even the Nasni, in case of Nasni, you will not find the high yielding varieties because all these crops are pocket specific. Then farmers won't get ample amount of seed from the government, or even in the market, you will not get the seeds for sowing. The next important point is a lack of cultivation and post harvest processing technology. again, always here, whenever we talk about the constraints, the problems, we have to compare with the other cereals. We have to compare with wheat, rice, and maize. Because if you go through the figures, or if you check the production of these three crops, then these three crops occupies top position as far as the agriculture productions are concerned. Then again, here you will not find the technology which required for the processing of all these millets. At the same time, the lack of public and marketing support. This is most important thing. If you go to ration shop, then you will get a wheat rice, but you won't get millet there, because yet millet not become the part of the public distribution system, and means there is no marketing support also. Then lack of bioprocessing or a value addition technique. All the millets are very nutritious. I'll come to this point, but apart from the nutritious attributes, the crop is highly ignored, because in millets you will not find any kind of, or the use of various bioprocessing techniques, simple techniques like malting and fermentation, though these are the conventional techniques. Then next important point is change in food habit. You will find encroachment of the other food, for example Chinese, as compared to the millets, as when we compare with our local food. Then you will find more demand for example Chinese as compared to the local. So change, not this is one of the example, but change in food habit is one of the factor which ignore the importance of millet. So this is the lack of awareness, and the most important thing is there is no bridge between the farmers and laboratories. And finally, the most important issue is the lack of political support. Here I specifically mention Odisha, because nowadays Odisha become a role model for the millet production. In Odisha, you'll find a great support, great political support for the millet mission. Such mission you won't find in Maharashtra or any other state of our country. Then millets are highly specific. They are very specific because, as I said, they are highly nutritious, number one. They contain very good amount of protein. Not only protein, but if you go through the protein fractions, albumin, globulin, proliamine, you will find a very good amount of these fractions. Then number two, antioxidant. Millets contain very good amount of phenolic compounds, and these phenolic compounds can be used as an antioxidant, as a source, as a natural source of antioxidant, or we can say the very cheap and natural source of antioxidant. Then number three, amino acids. Amino acids are far more important as far as our body mechanism is concerned. So amino acid, different types of amino acids, for example, leucine, lysine, tryptophan, tyrosine, and one of the most important amino acid is the methionine, because methionine is sulfur containing amino acid. In millets, you will find very good amount of all these amino acids, specifically methionine. Then all the millets also contain very good amount of vitamins, vitamin A, or what is other vitamins. Then, as I said, the polyphenols, gallic acid, synergic acid, various fractions of the polyphenols you will find. And most important thing are the minerals. All the millets are a very good source of mineral. For example, Nasni. In Nasni, you will find very good amount of calcium. This is the only crop which contain highest amount of calcium. The amount of calcium is 344 milligram per 100 gram. And you may find the 344 or even the 355, it goes up to 360 milligram per 100 gram as the crop shows tremendous diversity. Along with the calcium, the crop also contain very good amount of iron. The range of iron is 3.9 milligram to near about 12.5 milligram per 100 gram. And along with these two, or we can say this is the only crop which exhibit good amount of calcium and iron, or the best combination of these two. And along with these two, you will find the sodium, potassium, magnesium, manganese in good amount. So such combination or such nutritional attributes, we will not find in other crops or in other cereals, even when we compare with the rice and wheat. Then when we compare with rice and wheat, then all the millets are far superior. All the millets are nutritionally superior over to other cereals in terms of protein, in terms of antioxidant and amino acids. So here in the comparison, the chart will give the comparison of the carbohydrate, protein, fat, energy, calcium. Here remain these crops, these six millets, and comparison with the wheat and rice. When compare with these two, wheat and rice, then all this figure shows that all the millets are very nutritious, very, very nutritious. Then there are number of policies as far as the government or central government and the state government policies are concerned. And these policies, first important policy is Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. I'm emphasizing these two policies because these two policies are deals with the conservation, promotion of millets. First is the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. Under RKVY, important policy is initiative for nutritional security through intensive millet promotion. And second policy is also part of Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, that is the rainfed area development program. And one more policy is the macro management of agriculture, which include integrated cereal development program in coarse cereal. All these millets are called as a coarse cereal, or in Marathi, all these millets are called as a bharat dhanya. But instead of bharat dhanya, nowadays one more term we people use, and that term is dev dhanya instead of bharat dhanya. Why dev dhanya? Because the crop is highly nutritious and carries n number of good qualities. So what are the measures which required or which needed to boost the production of millets or to boost the use of millets? There are two different policies which can be at the production level and the demand level. Here the evolving demonstrations and support for location specific package of practices. Then support for seed production. As I said in the beginning, Malli, this is the crop which specifically grown in the hilly area or of the tribal farmers. And this crop is not much more aware by the urban people or even by the policy maker. So the seed production is one of the most important issues. If the seeds are available, then definitely remember it's possible to increase the area under cultivation. then support for selective mechanism. Mechanism before and after cultivation. For example, post-processing technology. We have to develop such technologies. Then support for drying and threshing yard. You won't find such facilities in case of millets. Then financial supports are is most important because the crop is ignored crop by the policy maker, by the government, and even by the industry people. And the last important is support for marketing. And here the second part is the demand side. In case of the demand side, here we have to include, or government must include, all the millets in public distribution system. This is the need, or this is the most important issue. Then support for small processing unit. Means we have to find out, we have to invent different techniques which can be used for the processing of millet. And the most important is the awareness campaign. We have to make people aware regarding the nutritional importance of millet. Along with the nutritional importance, you may find the number of the health support properties. So this remain about the introduction of the millets. What are millets? What are the government policies and all these things? Now let's come to the our work, how we are working in this area. Specifically, we are working on all the millets, but here I would like to share the work on finger millets only. So finger millet in Marathi is called as a nasni. Already I given the importance of all the millets. This again, millet, finger millet is not an exception. Nasni is not an exception. It's a crop for nutritional security, shows great genetic diversity, disease resistance crop, short duration crop, grown in wide environment, required less water, free from chemicals, high fodder value, high storage, and climate resilient crop. And obviously, along with the nutritional property, it also carries the medicinal values. So here already I given you the importance of the various nutritional component, and these are the component which specifically appear in case of the finger millet. Minerals, different types of mineral, here you can see the calcium, phosphorus, potassium in very high amount, natural antioxidant like phenolic compounds, caffeic acid, ferulic acid, and vanillic acid. Then the fractions of the protein, amino acid, and vitamins like riboflavin and thiamine. So from the last 10 years, we are working on finger millet. We are working on the conservation of the land races. And along with the conservation, the nutritional analysis of the conservation. Because whenever we talk about the agricultural crop, always we insist on the production. Means production per acre, production per hectare. But nobody asks the nutritional qualities, or we always ignore the nutritional qualities. Even the government or the policy maker or we people ignore the nutritional values of the crop. So specifically from the last few years, we are working on the conservation of the land races and land races throughout Maharashtra, and the nutritional analysis of all these land races. So throughout Maharashtra, we have collected 120 land races. Let me clear you what exactly mean by land races. Land races are the local varieties or the varieties grown by the local people. These are not developed by the agriculture universities or by any seed company. So these land races are highly specific. They are pocket specific. And our research shows that all these land races, local varieties, they are highly specific and they are nutritious over to the varieties developed by the universities. No doubt, when we compare in terms of the yield or in terms of the production, then production of the land races are little bit less as compared to the standard varieties. But in terms of the nutrition, these are highly nutritious. So from the last few years, we collected 120 land races, or we can say we have the germplasm of seeds of 120 land races. Out of 120 land races, we analyze 64 land races for their morphological characters. Here you can show the diversity of finger millet. This is the diversity of Nasni grown in the Maharashtra. In the beginning stages, it's not possible to find out the differences. But whenever the head develop, here you can see the differences. This is the head. It's called the finger millet. We call it finger millet because this is Nasni. This is the head, shows the fingers, number of fingers. And these fingers are arranged in specific fashion. And as this is the small grain cereal, we call it as a finger millet. Each head carries near about 10 to 12 fingers, and each finger contains grains. And the nature of the grain, arrangement of the grains are differ, arrangement of the fingers are developed, number of fingers are differ from region to region. As I said, there are no varieties, but all these are the local land races. And these land races, as because of the encroachment of the cash crops or the shifting of the land for the cash crops, these land races are gradually disappears. So here you can see the variation in the land races, and here you can see this is the pigmentation. As I said, it's not in the beginning, it's not possible to identify the differences because finger millet is belong to grass family. But later on, it's a short duration crop, but after there are about 30 to 35 days, you'll find development of the pigment developed on the stem. Is the black pigment or the white here, like such pigment. So depending on that, you'll find different local names like Kari Peri, Pandri Peri. So this remain the difference, or the we can say the diversity of finger millet in Maharashtra. Here you can see that again more inflorescence are differences in the finger millet land races. Out of 120, we have screened near about 10 land races on the basis of nutritional component. And all these 10 land races, they contain very high amount of calcium, iron, high amount of protein, then sugar, various types of amino acids, and the polyphenols. So these are the grains of land races, finger millet land races or Nasni land races, which we conserved or which we are conserving from the last few years. Here, all these grains, they are highly nutritious over to standard varieties. So important thing is the conservation of the land races. Now here remain the analysis, protein, how much amount of protein, how much amount of carbohydrate, or reducing sugar present in all these 10 land races. Here we given number, instead of number we given T1, T2, T3. These numbers we given to the land races. Here you can see the phenol, flavonoids and tannins. Then the mineral analysis of all these land races. So this is the range of 159.7 to 364.6 milligram calcium per 100 gram. Likewise, here you can see the amount of iron, potassium, magnesium, zinc, copper. Here remain the range. Here, this remains about the phenolic compounds, technique known as, and this technique used to find out the fractions of phenolic compounds. These phenolic compounds can be used as an antioxidant. Nowadays in market, you may find the synthetic antioxidant also. A number of times doctor described to take antioxidant. Now, this is one of the important part as far as the nutrients are concerned. Bioprocessing. There are three different types of technique we use to enhance or to increase the nutritional component, like protein or the minerals or amino acids. And these three techniques are conventional techniques. It won't require any amount or won't require any training. These three techniques are germination, malting and fermentation. Our ancestor knows about these things, and even we people also knows about germination, malting and fermentation. But then what we have done exactly? We tried to standardize the process of germination or malting and fermentation. Means after how many hours, for example, 8 hours of malting. Malting means ambavne Marathi madhe. Fermentation and malting he ambavne madhe itat. Specifically, the time is most important. How much time required for the malting or fermentation, and after specific duration, you will find the increase in the nutritional component and decrease in the anti-nutritional factor. Because in case of nasni, you will find very high amount of tannin. And this tannin interfere in the bioavailability of all the minerals or the nutritional component. But with the malting, it is possible to reduce the amount of tannin. Means we can, in the simple word, we can say, we can remove or reduce the anti-nutritional compounds, and it is possible to enhance the nutritional component or to improve the digestibility and the bioavailability of the nutritional compounds. So this compound, so this process are germination. Here you will find the sprouting. Again, this is very common. Sprouting mujhe mood aane Marathi madhe. Okay, what exactly happened during all this process? Whenever we use the malting or sprouting processes, then during this process, number of endogenous enzymes produces within the seeds, and these enzymes helps to release the various nutritional components. This is the process of malting. Anybody can use this process. First is the cleaning of the seed. For cleaning, remove the foreign particles. The next is steeping. Steeping means here soaking of the seeds in water for a specific time. What exactly happened by soaking or by steeping? It promote uniform and rapid germination of the seeds. Germination is one of the most important method which releases or which break down complex compound into simple compound. So this is the biochemical changes appear during germination, and then artificially or by exposing the seeds to the specific temperature, we ceases the process of germination, and this process known as kilning. Here, the halting germination process means we cease the process of germination. So these four are important steps. These four steps comes under malting. Then after malting, the next important process is the natural and standard fermentation. Again, this is the process. Here, there is difference between fermentation and malting. In fermentation, we won't allow germination. Rest of the process is as it is. Then specifically here, what is the importance of the fermentation process? This process done or complete with the help of microorganism, and microorganisms are most important because these microorganisms support a number of biochemical reactions which appear in our body. For example, gut contain maximum amount of microorganism, and if this microorganism kills, then definitely you will find the interference. So the maintenance of microflora is most important. And here, the fermented food of millet support the microflora. So here is the mechanisms. Okay, so here what exactly happened when malting or fermentation? After malting, again we check the nutritional components, means whether there is an increase or decrease in the protein, amino acid, phenol, or various compound, and we find out that malting and fermentation, both the processes, both the mechanism support or enhances the nutritional components. Then after that, here you can see the few recipes. All these recipes are prepared from nasni, absolute nasni, and other millets. Means why the crop is not popular? Why the millets are not popular? Because you will not find any bioprocessing as far as the other crops are concerned. And one more thing I would like to tell you, that in the market, what we have done here, we have collected the samples, Nagli biscuits or the Nagli recipes, whatever the products are available in the market, Mumbai, Nasik, and Pune market. We analyzed all these food products for their nutritional component. And we compare all these food products with our product. These products can be made very easily. It won't require much more training. And when we analyze the market product, we realize that the market product won't contain much more nutritional content. For example, the Nagli biscuits. Nagli biscuits are specifically, they are Nagli or Nasni is rich in calcium, but the cookies or the biscuits won't contain any amount of calcium or any kind of mineral. Because whenever these cookies are baked at very high temperature, then all the mineral content comes down. And after that, after preparation of all these recipes, we also analyze all these recipes for their mineral content. Here you can see the protein, carbohydrate, and all these content. So all these recipes, means what are the recipes we made, these recipes contain very high amount of nutritional component. When we talk about all the millets or the use of maximum millets, why? No doubt these are nutritious, but apart from the nutritious, you will find n number of health benefit. For example, again, if we come to nasni or the little millet or the foxtail millet, then they contain very high amount of fibers, when we compared the amount of fiber in wheat and the millet contain very high amount of fiber. And because of very high amount of fiber, you will find slow release of sugar in blood. So millets, all the millets are popular as a diabetic crop. Means we can use for diabetic patient, but the most important thing is that this is not only diabetic crop. But nowadays it's become popular because of its properties, because of its the very high amount of fibers. Or so it reduces the risk of diabetes. But apart from that, here you can see the various health benefit. For example, oxidative stress. We can reduce oxidative stress again by taking the millets, because millet contain very high amount of phenol, polyphenolic compound, and polyphenolic compound can be work as an antioxidant. Then here you can see the osteoporosis. Nasni and other millets, they contain very high amount of calcium. So we can say, we can reduce the chances of osteoporosis, means the calcium problem. Then it increases the immunity, as I say. Throughout, if we go through the profile of all the millets, then you will find very good amount, you will find the balance of all the nutritional component. So the millets increases the immune power. So this remains about the health power or the health benefit. And finally, what are the most important things are, we have to increase the consumption of millet. If there is increased demand for the millets, all the millets, then with the increased demand, the production will increase and the more area will come under cultivation. So we have to increase, we have to enhance the use of all the millet grains. Then number two, along with the other crops, the most important thing is the conservation, because you will not find maximum amount of millet cultivation. Millet cultivation restricted to specific areas only. And again, there you will not find the varieties. So the whatever varieties we have, whatever local varieties we have to conserve these varieties, otherwise after a few years you may not find such nutritional varieties or the land races. Then we have to maintain the seed bank, because there is a scarcity of seeds. If the seeds become available, then only the farmers or the people will use for cultivation. So community seed bank, regular supply of good quality seeds are most important. Next point is the value addition. Value addition means we have to increase the nutritional qualities by using various mechanism, by using various processes like fermentation, malting, brewing, or other mechanisms. And the most important thing is the increased awareness regarding all the millets to enhance the nutrition or to support the health, then agriculture, biodiversity, and ultimately economy of the country. So every year, specifically in the month of May, in the last year only because of COVID, we're not able to organize the workshop, but every year in our college, specifically on 22nd May, that is the Biodiversity Day, on that day, we always organize the workshop in our college, specifically regarding the guidance of means how to cultivate, how to promote the millets. And also through exhibition, we try to promote the millets, all the millets. So here remain the conservation. Here the awareness promotion programs and the conservation and multiplication of millet. So this remain about the millets. Thank you. Once again, I am thankful for the organizer for giving me opportunity to share my experiences. Thank you.
Thank you, Auti sir. Now from the participants, anyone having any questions, you can ask, please. Participants? So I'm guessing there's no any question from the participants. Thank you so much, Auti sir, for your fabulous presentation. We were honored that you were on our board. So
thank you.
Yes, thank you, sir.